The earliest writing approximations of pi are found in Egypt and Babylon, both within 1% of the true value. In Babylon, a clay tablet dated 1900 before Christ has a geometric statement that, by implication, treats pi as 3.12 and 50. In India, around 100 before Christ, the Shubha Sutras treat pi as approximately 3.088. In 150 before Christ, or perhaps earlier, India sources treat pi as 3.1622. Two verses in the Hebrew Bible describe a ceremonial pool in the Temple of Solomon with a diameter of 10 cubits and a circumference of 30 cubits. The verses imply pi is about 3 if the pool is circular. The development of computers in mid-20th century again revolutionized the hunt for digits of pi. American mathematicians John Range and Levi Smith reached 1,120 digits in 1949 using a desk calculator. Using an invert tangent arctan infinite series, a team led by George Heisenmeyer and John von Neumann, that same year achieved 237 digits, with a calculation that took 70 hours of computer time on the ENIAC computer. The iterative algorithms were adaptively published in 1975 to 1976 by American physicist Eugene Solomon and Australian scientist Richard Brandt. Those were widely used after 1980 because they are faster than infinite series algorithms. Whereas infinite series typically increase the number of correct digits additively in successive terms, iterative algorithms generally multiply the number of correct digits at each step. The benefit of formula for makings, which is a variation of the Gruber-Leibniz series, was that it had a significantly increased rate of convergence, which made it a much more practical method for calculation. To compute pi to 100 decimal places, he combined his formula with the Taylor series expansion for the inverse tangent. Machin's formula remained the primary tool of pi hunters for centuries, as well into the computer era. There are several methods of calculation pi. On the sample, we are using the John Machin formula for the reason that it's simple and fast for ordinary calculations. We don't expect to break any records here. The algorithm from Fractal Spring will use it for example, and we show you how to convert it, maintaining their simplicity and effectiveness of C++. The main function is for calculate the arctan. You can use the already defined. You can check it out at the Scala document reference. We aren't defining all the details about this function. I will show you only how to use it. If you want more details, check the website for Fractal Extreme. Define a function and name it arctan. It receives a big decimal and returns another one. We are using big decimals for maintaining the best precision possible. The C++ original function defines a result and a variable x squared. We declare the both as var. Result receives x and x squared x times x. Define a var named term. It receives x and the divisor int starting with 1. We create a loop while term is different than 0. Inside loop divisor, increment by 2. Term is multiplied by x squared and accumulates the value. Result decrement for itself by division of term and divisor. Divisor is incremented by 2. Result accumulated division between term and divisor. At last, we return the result. If we try to run, we can see it won't return. So we must change the condition in loop for the final desired precision for calculation. In this case, we change the condition of term different than 0. The big decimal class has an attribute named scale, and we can test if the decimal values was already reached trying something like term.scale is less than 100. Now we can test by ourselves and see the result of pi. Unfortunately, for the reason of the multiplications, we lost several decimal cases and couldn't calculate it for much more than that. Thank you.